Okay, hi 9th class students, how are you up to now? So there is a lag between you and me, last 4 months onwards. I think you are feel very better at home. Once again I say to you and warn you, stay at home, safe at home, because of the pandemic is going on. So that my suggestion is also to you, be stay at home. Today the new year, academic year, 9th class, you are coming to 9th class. The first chapter in the mathematics is real numbers. One time we are going to discuss the real numbers. Before doing this one, we have to discuss about the number system. Number system already we 8th standard also I said to you the number system. That's why directly I am saying the number systems how like how. The first one is set of natural numbers. So what are natural numbers? These numbers are also called the counting numbers. These are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so on. For us, the least natural number is obtained, but last natural numbers does not exist. For the set of whole numbers, when we add one more digit, that is 0, we get set of whole numbers. These whole numbers are represented by W. So these are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so on, and enclosed between the flower braces. Now we are going to discuss other ones. For the set of whole numbers, when we add some negative numbers, some of you have the doubts, what is the benefits of negative numbers? The reason is there. In the winter season, in our Ongole also, the temperature comes to very less, nearly 15 degrees, 16 degrees like that. At the same time, in the month of December and January, when we go to Jammu and Kashmir, the temperature comes to 0 degrees, and less than 0 degrees also will be obtained. When we heard the news in any news channels or in papers, the temperature come to minus 5 degrees, minus 4 degrees, like that. So like that, negative numbers are also there for us. Or otherwise, we have to do a business. So you kept 1000 rupees capital for a business. After doing 1 day or 2 days, you have get some loss. Why? Because that business you get you sell the article for 1000, no one can buy. After 2 days, what you have to do? That article sold by you by rupees 800 only, you got loss 200. So loss is represented as negative. That is why. So set of integers. So integers how like obtained for us? These are represented by I or Z. Why should we represent integers with two case letters? This is general notation. Integers first letter is I, so no problem. Why should we represent with Z? Johal Allen, a mathematician, introduced these numbers. In honor of him, we have to represent the integers with Z, Johal Allen numbers. Okay. So these are how like 0 to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so on like this. Towards backward direction, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, so on like this. These numbers are said to be set of integers. Finally, we have to write in another notation, 0 plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, plus or minus 3, plus or minus 4, plus or minus 5, so on. In categories of this set of integers, we have to get positive integers, negative, set of positive integers, set of negative integers, set of non-negative integers. How like we have to write it? The first one is, integers will be classified into three parts. The first one is set of positive integers. Set of positive integers represented with I plus or Z plus. So these are represented with I plus or Z plus. Those are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so on. Already we learned these numbers are set of natural numbers. So, the other name of set of natural numbers is set of positive integers. The next one is set of negative integers. So, what are the set of negative integers? These are represented with I minus or Z minus. These are minus, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, so on, like this. And the third one is set of non-negative integers. Non-negative integers. There is no special case letters indicated by the set of non-negative integers. So, what are the set of non-negative integers? These are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so on. These are non-negative integers. Already, the set of non-negative integers represented by set of whole numbers. So, some textbooks we learned set of whole numbers is nothing but set of non-negative integers. This is the classification of numbers. Rest of the ones also there for us. So, these are indicated by already this type of notes already there in the 8th standard. So, you have to copy it from the textbooks. Otherwise, we send one photo, afterwards write the and upload it to WhatsApp group. Okay, next one, set of rational numbers. Set of rational numbers, how like we have to represent? Already you learn in 8th standard only, but once again I have to say to you, any rational number which is in the form of P by Q and Q not equals to 0, P comma Q belongs to set of integers, such type of numbers are said to be set of rational numbers. Rational, for example, I have to say one example. Your father will bring a dilpasand to you and to your brother. You have to take some part of that dilpasand. Entire one you can't eat at the same time. So, some of that one you have to cut into 4 pieces. One part eaten by you, other part eaten by your brother. So, how much part eaten by you? Let us see. This is dilpasand. This one is cut into 4 pieces. Portion of the dilpasand eaten by you. One part, it is divided into 4 parts. One of the part eaten by you, this is what one? A rational number. The second part eaten by your brother. So, this is the second part. So, your brother also eat 1 by 4. Third part eaten by your father, fourth part eaten by your mother. So, these like we have to represent the rational numbers. So, next one. So, these rational numbers are how like we have to represent? Rational numbers are represented in the two forms. They are in the P by Q form. The other one is rational form. I am sorry. That is decimal form. Every number 1.56. This is the decimal form of a rational number. 7 by 5. This is the rational form of a rational number. Minus 11 by 17. This is the rational number. These are the examples of rational numbers. Next ones, other ones also there. The set of irrational numbers. So, what are irrational numbers? Set of irrational numbers. Before saying this one, I have to say some more about rational numbers. Why? Because every rational number can be expressed as either a terminating decimal or non-terminating repeating decimal or recurring decimal. But what about the irrational numbers? Irrational numbers are denoted by Q dash. These numbers are the numbers which are not in the form of P by Q and non-terminating repeating, non-terminating, non-repeating. Such type of numbers are said to be irrational numbers. These are root 2, root 3, root 5, root 7, like this. These are all said to be irrational numbers. Now, the union of, next going to the main topic of the lesson, real numbers. The union of set of irrational numbers set of irrational numbers together are called the real numbers. So the real numbers is nothing but, real numbers are denoted by the letter R. It is denoted as Q union Q dash. Sometimes this one denoted by S also. Real numbers are the union of rational and irrational parts together are called real numbers. Tomorrow class we have to continue in the same process. Bye children, stay at home and safe at home.